Spry's Comics.
Easy, easy, boys, easy.
Spry's Comics.
All right, welcome to Spry's Comics. Today we have a very special guest, the first appearance of Katie in a 9.8 with White Pages. How are you feeling, babe?
Good.
So it's been a long time coming. I've been trying to get her to come on the show, but you know, with a kid and everything, it's super hard to make it happen. So thank you for being here. Are you excited to unbox these CGC comics?
Oh my God. I am just so excited, babe.
Katie.
I mean, this is what I've been waiting for.
She's been waiting patiently. Before you guys comment, you know, how cool it is that I have a wife that's like totally into comics and stuff. She tolerates it. Okay, she tolerates comics, and she's absolutely not into it. Before we crack into those boxes, I want to give a couple announcements about the website. We have some pre-orders. We have Something's Killing the Children 16, the Sajjad Shah exclusive cover. There's only a couple of those available over on the website. The Something's Killing the Children 16, you guys have heard me talk about it 100 times before. It's a super important book to the story, origin of Erica Slaughter, first appearance of Jessica. And this exclusive cover just stuck out to me above all of the rest. So I went a little crazy on them, but I'm only going to have a limited number available for pre-sales, and I expect the price to go up when I actually get them back in hand. Remember to place separate orders if you're going to order any of the in-stock items so that I can ship as they become available. And also, we do still have some Spawn number 9s available over on the website. First appearance of Angela, first appearance of Cagliostro, and first appearance of Medieval Spawn. And I thought that this spec was all about Angela, right? Until recently when I saw the new Spawn Universe series has Medieval Spawn on one of the variant covers. And so even more spec going on with this book now, which might be why the price is continuing to see increases. Let's give them a discount code. What discount code do you want to use, babe?
How about Wonder Woman?
Wonder Woman, all caps for 10% off everything in stock on the website. So use that discount code, and I believe that's the cheapest price that you'll be able to find this book for anywhere. All right, so with that said, let's crack into these boxes. All right, so Something is Killing the Children, number 1, Local Comic Shop Day Foil Edition. Says there on the label, first appearance of Erica Slaughter and foil cover. Try to catch it in the light, babe, so you can see that foil effect. It's kind of hard to catch on camera, but the camera definitely doesn't do it justice. This cover is absolutely gorgeous in the foil version. And a little bit about this book. So Something is Killing the Children, number 1, cover A, had a print run of about 33,000, and the Local Comic Shop Day edition has a print run of about 30,000. So it's actually more rare than the cover A. But that said, I think that the Local Comic Shop Day is going to have more high-grade copies than the cover A, because the cover A was just read to death. I bought like 7 or 8, maybe even 9 complete collections of Something's Killing the Children, and every single one of them, issue number 1, had been read and read and read, because you know, nobody was specking on it when it came out, and it was an awesome, compelling story. So the 7th print, or the Local Comic Shop Day, most people bought it just to collect it. Most people weren't reading this. So I do believe there will be more high-grade copies, even though it's a lower print run. With the price of cover A, like well over $1,000, this is just an awesome alternative. I mean, if you have super deep pockets and you can afford that $1,300 cover A, I would go for that. But if not, you can pick up the 7th print here and get the exact same cover enhanced with the foil goodness effect. And then use that money that you would have had to shell out for cover A to put in some other spec books and flip. So I think what's going to be the case with this book and pretty much everything in that box is now is a terrible time to sell this book and a really good time to buy this book, because we're seeing kind of a lull in prices. There just hasn't been a ton of talk about Something that's Killing Children in the news, and we're still waiting for that big announcement to come from Boom Studios about the show being made. And when we do, expect this book to hit the trending lists again and start going through the roof once again. And then we still have the show coming out. I mean, it was so early on in the grand scheme of this series and hopefully soon to be TV show. But, you know, I got to keep things moving. I can't just sit there and hold on to all of these copies. So what do you think is killing the children, babe?
The title makes me cringe.
Yeah, my mom's not a big fan of the title either. But you'll be happy to know that Erica is protecting the children.
Hmm.
Yeah. Okay. So. Anyways, even in fact, my son, every time he sees the Jay Lee cover, he goes, and she's the protector, Daddy? I go, yep, she's the protector. So let's see how many copies of that we got. All right, so 20 copies of Something's Killing Children, number one, local comic shop day, foil edition. Super tempted to put all of those up on the back wall just to see what it would look like with that many slabs. But you guys, again, the camera does not do these books justice. They look incredible in person. All right, let's see what else we got. All right, Department of Truth number one, the 1 in 25 Inyahuk Lee incentive cover. And this book just doesn't get enough love. It's the 1 in 25, so it's way more rare than the cover A, and it's selling for less than the cover A. It's also ties for the first cover appearance of the Lady in Red, a super important character to the story. So I just don't understand why it doesn't get more love than it does, but the market dictates. And so let's see how many of those we got. Five. So five copies of that. So that we went 25 for 25 in that box. That's good. That means we didn't get any rejects. So yeah, there we go. 25 of 25 for that box. Super good start. All right, here we go. Box number two. Oh, here's one you guys have probably never seen me unbox before. Just kidding. It's some more of the 1 in 25s. You could just zip through these. So five more of the 1 in 25s. And then we have Department of Truth number one, the second print. The second print is definitely more rare than the first print. Retailers had way less of an incentive to buy the second print because with the first print, you had 1 in 10s, 1 in 25s, 1 in 50s, and 1 in 100 incentive ratios to place bigger orders. And there was a huge print run for cover A. So the second print's definitely less of a print run. But as you guys probably know, we're already up to the fifth print, but this one, the second print, seems to be holding a decent value. It's pretty darn close to that first print. So let's see how many copies of that we got. Ten. So 10 copies of the second print. A little bit more affordable than the first print, and I actually just prefer to look at the second print over the first because of, you know, the color splash on there with the blue tones. Again, this is another book that is just a terrible time to sell. If I had more space and more funds, I would just hold on to all of these books because we still have so many announcements and so many opportunities for this book to spike. So let's see what else we got. All right, Invincible Iron Man number one. This is the first cover appearance of Riri Williams as Ironheart. Again, another book that is a terrible time to sell and a wonderful time to buy. This book is seeing a little bit of a lull right now because Riri is not in the spotlight. Her show has been confirmed. It's coming to Disney Plus, the Ironheart series, with I think it's Dominic Thorne cast as Riri Williams. But that's not coming until April of 2022. So less than a year away. And I mean, you can count on seeing spikes in all of the Riri books as we get closer to that show. I mean, we see it time and time again. Right now, all the focus is on Loki, and there's a couple other feature-length MCU movies coming out, so we're not gonna hear any news about Riri, really, until the show gets closer, so it's a great time to buy it. Let's see how many copies of that we have. So, 8 copies of Invincible Iron Man number one. Be on the lookout for all of the Riri keys, not just this book. All of her major keys, we'll definitely see a spike when the trailer comes out and when the show actually comes out. I mean, just look at what happened with Falcon Winter Soldier keys right around the time it being released, or WandaVision, or now the Loki. I mean, the books have gone crazy in this last week. So now is a great time to pick up those Riri William keys. All right. And so, Department of Truth, the 1 in 50, the Mirka and Dolfo incentive cover. I only have a couple of these left on the website, and I do believe this is my last batch with the 1 in 50, so it's the last chance to get it at this price. And Department of Truth number 1, cover A. Some of those still available on the website. Don't forget, use that code, what did we say, Wonder Woman?
Mm-hmm.
Wonder Woman, all caps, for 10% off everything in stock on the website. Thank you so much for helping us get through these boxes. You have anything to say to Bryce Comics fans?
Yeah, thank you guys for supporting Bryce Comics.
There you go, you guys. She's the voice behind the intro. Maybe next time we'll do something a little more entertaining than just pulling comics out of a box. Leave a note in the comments if you have any ideas on what you would like to see. Maybe we could do some kind of fun trivia. Test Katie's comic book knowledge, which is vast.
Zero.
Anyways, thanks so much for tuning in, you guys, and we will catch you in the next video.
Peace.
Bye.